Hi, she was seven. I'm back. Yes. How do y'all like my hair? Do I look cute? Sexy? Well, I have this wig on for a reason. This video is going to be about how to create an online dating profile. I know a lot of women have to date online, and I'm going to give y'all some tips and rules on how to create a profile that will represent you properly. Okay, first of all, y'all know I look good, right? But this is not how I look on the daily. This is not how I look normally, right? So I would not put a picture of myself that looks like this as my main profile picture. Why? Because this is not who I am. Okay, this is not what I look like on the daily basis. So ladies, use a picture that looks like you on a day-to-day basis, a current picture that represents what you look like in real life. Try to use as less filtering as possible, because sometimes that filtering will take away a few years, and some guys will be like, okay, she looked like she was 25, and then when I met her, she looked 45. And I'm not downing anybody who's 45, I'm just saying. Some guys thought they were getting a younger or young looking woman, and they had, they had went to meet her and she looks older than them. So we need to stop the filtering on the profile pictures. We need to put a correct representation of ourselves on the profile picture, because if someone saw this and they wanted to meet me and I came with my black curly hair and probably a lot less makeup on, then they're gonna be disappointed. You know, they're gonna be mad. They might not call me back. They're gonna be like, okay, well, I thought I was getting a blonde bombshell, and I'm, you know, but I got the curly haired lady that I don't even like curly hair. You know, I love my curly hair, y'all. I would never dye my hair blonde, just so y'all know. So, and not nothing against blondes. Blondes are beautiful. This just, I love myself, you know. Okay, so the next thing you want to do is take a bunch of pictures. You need a body shot, because sometimes we all take pictures from the neck up, and I'm guilty of this. The only reason it's hard for me to take full pictures is because I'm so damn tall. That's why I invented the selfie stick, y'all. Use it. Okay, get yourself a selfie stick and take a picture of what you look like for real, because you might be too tall for them, too skinny for them, too this for them, too that for them, and then you're gonna waste all this time getting to know someone and you're not even their type. Okay, men have types, and that's where, you know, the disappointment sets in when you meet in person. You're not even my type. I like, you know, I like thin, I like thick, I like tall, I like, you know, this, I like that, and I didn't see. And don't put an old picture when you were skinny or when you had gained weight. Use the most current picture you have. Okay. Next, how you dress. If you dress very nice, ladylike, and feminine, and, you know, casual, you're not going to be treated like a hoochie, a whore, a slut, someone to just use and throw away. You have to represent yourself as a classy lady with a lot of class, nice clothing, not showing everything, because as soon as a man goes on online to see women he wants to date, and he sees cleavage and tight clothes and bunch of makeup, he's thinking sex. He's not thinking girlfriend or future partner. He's like, oh, that's a good one to have sex with. So you don't want to look like that on your dating profile. You want to be covered up completely. You want a nice casual body shot of you in some decent clothes that aren't too revealing or too tight. Okay, you don't want all your pictures to be at the club or out drinking. You want your pictures to be like, you know, in cool places, like, you know, a park, or, you know, maybe a restaurant, or maybe somewhere that's not too, you know, like you're always out and about meeting people. Make it look like, you know, you're comfortable at home out in a restaurant, but you're not all about clubbing and meeting people and just partying. You know, guys don't like to see that. Okay. Also, show an intellectual side. Like if you have the option to show more photos, you know, show yourself reading, show yourself doing some arts and craft or whatever you like to do, jewelry making. So let them know that you have a hobby and you have a focus in life and you have talent and skills, you know. Yes, show your teeth. If you got messed up teeth, they need to know that, because you can smile like this, and then as soon as they see you, they're going to see all of this, and that's going to turn them off, and they're going to be like, okay, well, I thought, you know, I don't know what I mean. So make sure they see your teeth, because sometimes, you know, people like to hide things online, and then they have to meet you. Just show them before you waste your time and your gas money, okay? And some people might think a gap is cute. I know I have a little gap. Some people think it's cute. Some people say, oh, you need to fix your teeth. I say, well, I'm going to show you what I got, and you don't like it, then bounce, okay? So always show your teeth, because especially guys do this more than women. Guys will not show their teeth, and then when you meet them, they got like jacked up teeth or gold, too many gold teeth, and or not, or missing teeth or whatever, okay? Yellow teeth. Show your teeth on your garage, okay? Okay. And the next thing you need to do, like when you're writing your profile, what you're looking for, don't ever say you're looking for a husband. Just say, I am looking for a life partner, a best friend. Don't say, I'm looking for a man, I'm looking for a sugar daddy, I'm looking for this, I'm looking, say, I'm looking for a best friend, I'm looking for a future life partner or something like that. Don't ever say I'm looking for marriage, because that scares a lot of men away. Don't ever say I'm looking for a sugar daddy, because that's like gold digger alert, and they figure you do that with everybody. Just say I'm looking for a best friend who's generous in nature, loving, kind, sweet, but make sure you have generous up in there, okay? It doesn't have to be the first word, it can be like the last word, because most guys are going to go about what you put first, and then, you know, generous can be last. But make sure it's in there so that they know that you're not going to be paying for dinner, okay? Say you like traditional, old-fashioned gentlemen if you don't want to pay for your date, okay? I like the traditional, old-fashioned gentleman. That's going to let them know right there you're not for the okey-doke, okay? That means they have to come correct with you. If you got kids, don't put that you have kids or that you don't have kids, and don't put picture of your kids up, okay? Let them meet you first, and then let them ask you. If they ask you online on your profile, then you just say, yes, I do, okay? But don't put photos of your kids. Don't say that you have kids. Why? Because sometimes people will swipe past you or click past you just because you have kids, and they will not get to know you. They don't know your situation, da 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 da. But once someone gets to know you, then they can decide, okay, well, do I want to deal with a woman with kids? Don't let them prejudge you because you have kids, okay? Plus, you know, a lot of guys will, you know, they'll target women with kids because they think they're easier and that they're desperate. So don't ever put that you have kids, okay? Unless they ask you. Don't put it on your profile, okay? That's an important one, and it's sad, but that's just the way that you're going to be treated equally to the other ladies, okay? Now, or if you don't, if it says education, income, I know some of these places, I mean, like online profiles, like education, income, da 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 da, just like ask me. Don't put it on there. Just say ask me, or self-employed, or you know, just say ask me. Don't ever put all your business out, because that takes away your mystery. You need to tell these people this if you choose for them to know. Okay? So, just putting that out there. Anyway, also, choosing someone online, you need to check all the same things. The teeth, the most recent picture, You need to ask as many questions as you can, and you need to be very observant of the type of people that are on here, because some of them are crazy. Yeah, I'm serious. But remember, do not put this as your profile picture if this is not what you look like, okay? You're gonna attract the wrong type of people, and you're gonna be wasting a lot of time. If you change your hair often, put different hairstyles on each picture so that they know that they're getting a chameleon, okay? All right, thank y'all so much for watching. Thumbs up if y'all have something to add to this. How about your worst online dating experience? If you want to put that in the comments, I would love to read them, because I think it's hilarious. Sometimes y'all's stories are crazy and quite entertaining to me. So go ahead and put them in the comments, and I will see y'all later. All right. Bye.